John actually started singing, I want to say his first paying gig was at the pub in Winters with him and his buddy Chase McGrew. I think they were 16. So when he got off the stage to take a break, he had to go outside and stand on the sidewalk because he wasn't 21.
We went over, hung out at his house, and he was ripping on a guitar. I'm like, that's pretty cool. I want to do that. So he started showing me chords, and then he drove me to the bars to try to play some music.
He was with a band called Northern Comfort, and they started playing there a lot. Same thing with the Buckhorn, and he loved playing the Buckhorn in Dixon.
You set the precedence here for me, because now I don't think there is not a live band that can touch what you did.
Me and Jeremiah, we come up here and play right there on like a Thursday. There'd be like 15 people in here.
They'd play up here, and then they would have a bouncer at the door checking IDs with the line all the way out.
It had like more of like an outlaw kind of feel to it, you know, rather than the pop country stuff that was going on and people were listening to. It was more edgy, a little more rock and roll.
I met John here at Chico State. I was working on a music project for my recording arts degree, and I needed a band.
Here we are.
Came across this guy, this other guy named John, that was playing mandolin with John. And I told him, you know, if you've got a band, come into the studio. So they both came into the studio here and recorded a demo track.
When he was recording in Chico, he played me the demo. And it sounded really good. I go, oh my gosh, John, where'd you get all these people? He goes, Mom, we pulled them off the street.
Yeah, I just remember like thinking, man, this guy is cool. Like, I feel like we could be friends. And then, you know, and then sure enough, kind of took off from there.
Jeremiah quit going to Comfort because it was December, we weren't gigging, he had no money, he had to go back and borrow.
I remember this, actually. I remember hearing about it.
We all broke up. Then when we didn't have a band anymore, I was like, whatever, man, I'm going to Nashville.
I told her I'm moving to Nashville. I had a date set, and it was like maybe 8 months away. So it had some time to sink in, and then, I don't know, maybe she didn't even know if I was going to do it, you know?
Oh my gosh, she didn't even remember. He called me on the phone. And he said, I want to do something in music, and I'm really not doing anything in school. I'm just going through the motions. He goes, can I get what my college tuition and what's left of it and go out to Nashville? I really want to try. You said you didn't want to be a 40-year-old sitting in a bar thinking, what if? Jonathan went in there, and most songwriters has a book, and he had a notebook with handwritten songs that he actually wrote from home, and you know, that's what he brought.
We had songs, we're ready to showcase, we're start doing shows, and the first showcase I ever did.
It goes so well.
We practiced with the band one time, and same band, this is the same band I had for 5 years. So we practiced one time, and somehow Jennifer, she sold a couple big label, you know, big label presidents to come, and one of them was Mike Dongan, and so he saw the show, and I was like, wow, man, what do you think? And Autumn was like, well, he said to fire the band. So after that, we was like, well, we're gonna have to practice more. So we went and hit it 4 days solid of practice and got really tight. And then we kept doing showcases. And by the third time, Mike finally made it back to the show because he kept missing it. And he gave me a handshake deal.
Thank you, everybody, for making this my first gold record ever. That's a big deal for a Dixon boy. I'm just telling you, thank you so much.
The first time I heard his song on the radio, I had to pull over because I was screaming. I was just screaming. It was just so exciting. No tears, just screaming. And a couple other times, you know, I'm hearing him on the radio, and then I'm thinking, God, that's my CD's playing. And then I realize, oh, no, that's him on the radio. And then I start laughing, you know, and I'm just so proud. It just brings a big smile on my face.
He was actually here doing an interview, and they played it 2 or 3 times, like pretty much all that day. I was at work, and we came back here, and we had a big old party.
Every song that Alan has a feeling behind it as me growing up. You know, you hear it, and you get that feeling. You remember me singing along with my grandma, or me driving a tractor, or, you know, just being out in the country and Alan coming on. It's kind of crazy to be on tour with him, you know?
It's like, wow, that's my good friend who's doing that. That's amazing.
Saying hi to the ladies. Zoom in. They're cute.
You got him.
You never lose that home feel.
He's always had a knack for writing good songs, for making them catchy. It's like a well with that guy. They just don't quit.
Helen, thanks for having me on tour, buddy.
Yeah, man, I appreciate the show tonight.
It was good. It's a good crowd out there, man. They're ready for you.
I think there's no stopping him.
Oh, it's awesome to see your kid up there in front of 30,000 people. Sometimes still don't believe it.
Oh my God. My mother would be very proud. Hey, everybody!